Within Drakan, there rested the soul of a mortal man. A mortal whose courage and honor moved Freya herself. When she chose him as her blessed champion, Drakan's loyalty to Freya knew no bounds. As his conquests in her name grew, so too did Drakan's affections. For it seemed to him that to look upon Freya was to look upon the face of love itself. But mortal hearts are fragile. They are not meant to touch the divine. When Freya spurned Drakan's love and released him from his bonds, he wandered the lands in anguish. Obsession grew to madness, madness to emptiness. And that is when Hel, queen of the underworld, found him and made him her own. Hel offered him her protection, and in return, he'll become her harbinger and lead her dark army against Midgard. For Drakan, this was not only a chance to relive his former glories, but a chance for revenge. The more Drakan fought in Hel's name, the further away from Midgard he grew, until he became more akin to beast than man. It is said that only the giver may undo a divine blessing of immortality. Yet there are weapons forged for the undoing of many things in this world. Blessings, curses, even such weapons that can undo a goddess's will.
This is the Isle of Galcliff, Skarin, home to the settlement of Holdenfort. Once this vibrant port teemed with life. Now it is under Legion control and a place of only pain and death. Once you have gathered your army, you must seize back Holdenfort. There are many warriors to find. This distillery once brewed beverages fit for the tables of Valhalla. Now Hel's Legion have enslaved many of its workers. Free them, Skarin, for gratitude can often transcend to loyalty. But do not forget the dragons. Here on this isle, I sense the presence of another gem, Mugin. Yet its power is faint. It cannot be whole. Seek the parts of Mugin, my champion. Unite him with his brother Hugin in the dragon amulet.
How can I help you, Viking? Good day to you, warrior.
The forge is heated. What can I do for you? Looking for a bit more firepower, are you? See you like a bit of lightning power, do you? Well, I hope you can control it.
You may be fresh from the kill, warrior, but do not let that go to your head. Hell's forces are dug in deep on this isle. However, if the zeal for battle rages in your veins, I will not stand in your way. Yeah, you look in need of some aid, though. Farm and quarry should be able to provide some, although I fear they have troubles of their own. When you have muscle enough, head to the settlement of Holdenfort. My scouts tell me that Legion have their strongest troops stationed there. If you could find a way to destroy their barracks, then that would loosen the Legion's grip on Holdenfort as surely as greasing a sow on market day. But we take a step forward only to take two back. Those very same scouts who reported this news have not returned from their last excursion to the nearby hills. If you venture that way, keep your ears and eyes sharpened for any trace of them. Now, may you continue to shed Legion blood, my friend. The more you kill, then the less I have to. You look in need of some assistance, warrior. If you have skill enough to venture into the wilderness, Viking, then perhaps you can coax Midgard into giving up her hidden treasures. I have marked the area on your map, but be warned, such rewards are not easily come by, especially not in these dark times. Of course, if you do unearth anything, then be sure to spend it in my shop.
This building serves to produce the intoxicating liquids that you mortals seem to enjoy so much. But now is not the time for celebration, so it must be put to another use. Touch it with a flame and hurl it into the air, and it will rain scorching death down upon Hell's Legion. You must reclaim its place, Skarin, but be wary of the trolls. They are as tough as they are merciless.
My father never believed in the power of the gods, warrior, but he did believe in the power of a good drink. He was a master distiller, the best. He even created flame pots, weapons capable of great and fiery chaos. I have a few left, but if I had his original recipe, then I'm sure that I could keep you in regular supply. Ah, but Legion ransacked his house weeks ago and killed him. My only hope was that the drink saved him from the pain. Still, it might be worth your while going there and checking the cellar. He always kept that locked, but I have the key. Here, take it.
Thank you.
flame pots. As soon as I make more, I'll send them directly to Bodvar at the store. Others may have joined you out of gratitude or respect, even out of fear. But we will join for one reason and one reason only, and that is for profit. But these are troubled times, so we will lend our aid in this endeavor. Now, there's a Legion patrol carrying some tasty loot that passes near the Northern Tower. Clear the Tower of Legion, and we shall set up an ambush there. It's the perfect spot. Help us obtain that loot, and we'll call it payment enough.
I have been waiting for you, Skarin, and I sense other eyes upon you too. Look to the eyes of dragons, the eyes of wolves, the eyes of divinity. They are all watching. Ah, it has been a what?
wish to appear ungrateful for our liberty, stranger. But if you desire us to follow you into battle, then we will need more proof that you have what it takes to lead us. Legion have been observed entering the cave nearby. Return to us with it.
These stones were once a site for the Midgardians of old to worship the dragons. Reach out to them once more, Skarin. See if they will answer your call.